be means to be in motion. Movement is inherent in every aspect of existence, from the smallest single-cell organism to the most complex, from the hidden processes that make a flower possible to the Earth's many waters teeming with life, from the migration of birds, clouds, people, even to societies, nothing is static. Compared to other planets that so far show no signs of life, one glance at the Earth from space will tell you she's different. She just looks alive. But what regulates or maintains this lively planet? In the 1970s, two scientists, James Lovelock and Lynn Margulis, suggested that life itself plays a role in regulating or maintaining the climate and the atmosphere at an optimum level for life to continue. They called their hypothesis Gaia, after a Greek primordial goddess, mother of the Earth. They compared Earth's homeostasis, the ability to remain at a steady state, to processes in our own bodies that regulate our temperature, electrochemical balance, blood chemistry, and so on. Gaia is the study of the Earth's geophysiology, how it functions as an organism. Think of the Earth's oceans and rivers as her blood, the oxygen-producing forests as her lungs, the four layers of soil as her skin, and all living creatures, meaning you, as the Earth's senses. Today, there are many variations of the Gaia hypothesis. Some scientists disagree that the Earth is actually alive, but admit that life on Earth significantly impacts planetary processes. Others go further and claim the entire universe is alive. Look around. How do you define life? By your definition, is the Earth alive?